Eva, in the previous two videos, we talked about that candidates first tailor their resume and then they have the phone interview with the recruiter. Now they are facing the face-to-face interview with the recruiter or the hiring manager, and they are excited, they did their research of the company or the person they're going to interview. So what tips do you have in terms of preparing for the face-to-face interview? And at the end, what question they should ask that is different than the phone interview questions they ask?
Absolutely. So I think preparation, again, is very important. It was already important for the phone interview. It's just as important, at least, for the face-to-face interview. So, and now you have the opportunity to really show yourself. So also use the body language that we talked about before, but also make sure that your dress, and it sounds silly maybe or unnecessary, but your dress is sort of appropriate for the culture that you're going to. So that is part of that's part of doing that research, right? It doesn't mean you have to go in suit everywhere. Startups these days would more appreciate someone in jeans and sneakers probably, but it's good that at least you're not completely out of tone with the rest of the people in the company. So that might actually also, if you're not sure, be a question that you would ask that recruiter in that first phone interview, what the dress code is. So that is, you know, sort of logistics. Make sure you know where the office is, you're in time. That is all sort of no-brainers, you would almost say. But then in terms of, yeah, making sure that you do well, again, researching the company, researching the persons or the people, the person or the people that you are interviewing with, know their background. And then what I would say, if it's the hiring manager, the questions should be much more job related. I think a good question would always be, what would your expectation be that I deliver in the first 6 months on the job or 12 months? On the job, what would I be meeting expectations? When would I be exceeding your expectations? Is there any concrete, tangible results that you want me to drive? I think that is a good question, and it might be challenging the managers a little bit as well, because often they have not really thought that through. But it's a very important thing to think that through, right? So that's a good question. I would also think the question is a good one and an important one to say, if that is going to be the manager, right? Can you tell me a little bit about your leadership style? Because we know that a lot of people leave their companies because of their bosses, more so than for the companies. So you want to sort of check out what the style is, right? If the person says, well, I never even really thought about it, or I don't care much for development of people, which I hope they won't say, but you never know, then you might draw a conclusion from that, right? So I think that would be a good question as well. Concrete results on the job, as well as what is your leadership style, I think those are appropriate for hiring managers.
Yeah, I totally agree with you. I always say to my friend, I ask about what your leadership style is, you know, or is something like close to your heart. Let's say if you're a creative person and that's important to you, ask if they have, if the values of the company is also aligned with your values, and ask questions that are important to you, because working will be like a kind of a second home for you. So you need to make sure that that's a good fit for you as well as good fit for the company.
Yeah, absolutely. Another thing that I would now think of is as well, the question, what keeps you up at night? Or what is your biggest challenge or problem right now? So then I can see if I can help you solve it when I join, right? And maybe I can speak to that relevant experience that I've gained before that speaks to that, and that would show that I can actually help you solve that problem, right? So I think that you should definitely be asking questions. It's not a good sign, I would say, if you don't ask questions. So prepare that. And those are some examples of questions that
I agree with you. Totally ask questions at the end. It's important. And again, for the audience watching or listening, if you have any other questions that are beneficial or you think it's important for job seekers to ask at the end of the face-to-face interview, please leave it in the comment section. If you like the video, like and share, subscribe to the channel, and tune in tomorrow for my final question with Eva.